Hey guys, welcome to SkillLink. We see a lot of automobiles in our day-to-day life. The vehicles that we see have a wide range of variations in them. They vary in size, number of wheels, type of fuel used, purpose of the vehicle, and so on. In addition to all these, automobiles can also vary in the position of engine and location of the driving wheels. In this video, we're going to discuss the different types of layouts in automobiles. Commonly used layouts in automobiles are the front engine rear wheel drive, rear engine rear wheel drive, front engine front wheel drive, and four wheel drive. Let's check them out one by one. As the name says, front engine rear wheel drive vehicles have their engine located at the front and the drive is given to the rear wheels. Motion is transferred from the engine through the clutch, gearbox, propeller shaft, and differential to the driving axles. This type of layout is the most commonly used. The frontal location of the engine and gearbox provides easy access and makes it easy for maintenance. This also facilitates better engine cooling and offers more luggage space at the rear end. But the increased distance between the engine and drive wheels require a long propeller shaft and a tunnel has to be provided for it in the car floor. This can be seen in the Mahindra cars. Next, we have rear engine rear wheel drive vehicles. These vehicles have their engines at the rear side and the drive is also transmitted to the rear wheels itself. Because of the lesser distance between the engine and the drive wheels, the clutch and gearbox are held together in a single unit and short shafts are used to transmit power to the rear wheels. In this type, the steering mechanism is simple and easier to operate as the front wheels are only used to steer. There will also be better road adhesion of the wheels, especially in steeps. The rear location of the engine makes it easier to streamline the vehicle to decrease wind resistance, but the increased weight at the rear wheels make the vehicle unstable at high speeds. This placement of the engine also reduces luggage space and reduces engine cooling. This type of layout is used in buses and coaches that have low-level floors. In cars, Tata Nano uses this type of layout. The next type of layout is the front-engine front-wheel drive layout. It is completely opposite to that of the rear engine rear wheel drive. Here, the engine is located at the front and the drive is given to the front wheels. So, the front wheels have to perform both driving and steering actions. This type eliminates the need for a propeller shaft and affords more luggage space at the back. The engine on the front improves the traction, especially in corners, and avoids skidding of the front wheels to a certain extent. But the steering system is complicated and the rear wheels start skidding at heavy braking due to lesser weight at the back. This type of layout is very common and you can take an example of the Maruti 800 as an Indian car which uses this layout. At last, we have the four-wheel drive. In this type, the engine is located at the front and power is transmitted to all four wheels via a transfer case. It has a front and rear differential and this type increases the maneuverability of the vehicles traveling in rough roads and tracks. The major advantage of this layout is that it produces traction at all four wheels. If a pair of wheels gets stuck due to conditions like mud, the other pair of wheels help in moving the vehicle. On the other hand, the system is bulky, heavier, and of high cost. This type of layout is mainly used in off-road vehicles like Jeeps. Here, the transfer case is used to transmit an equal amount of torque to both front and rear axles. If a center differential is used to transmit power, then the drive is said to be all-wheel drive. Here, the front and rear axles can rotate at different speeds. An example for a vehicle that uses this layout is the Subaru Impreza, the Isuzu, and the Fortuner. With this, we have seen the most commonly used layouts in automobiles.